Today, let's go over the Star Wars franchise when it comes to Obi-Wan Kenobi and the moment in which he almost turned to the dark side of the Force. This is Mike Zero here. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. So the reason as to why I wanted to go over this amazing and interesting moment in a piece called The Last One Standing, though it is Legends, it goes deep into Obi-Wan's adventures on Tatooine and more. Now, there is a moment in this piece in which Obi-Wan Kenobi slips to the dark side of the Force, very much like Luke Skywalker did at the very end of Return of the Jedi, on board of the Death Star 2, while going up against his own father, Darth Vader, when he mentioned his own sister, Leia, and how he could quite possibly turn her to the dark side. So, if you guys go ahead and check out Episode 2, Attack of the Clones, Anakin Skywalker also, you know, has a moment in which he slips into the dark side of the Force when he essentially slaughters the Tusken Raiders. We see a very similar moment of this involving Obi-Wan Kenobi, a near reflection of that very given scene. Now, however, the moment in which Obi-Wan is all set and ready to leave, he is quickly discovered by a lone Tusken Raider, who later attacks him effortlessly. Though Obi-Wan was all able to disarm with ease, the Raider then yells, which informs all the other males in the camp area, that they have an intruder, which is the lone Jedi. They all decide to attack him repeatedly. Now, this is the moment in which Obi-Wan slowly starts to hate them, deeply, sparks of rage boiling up within himself, causing him to fall and slip to the dark side. But this is where things get very interesting. Slightly before he is able to hear a faint voice, the voice of Qui-Gon Jinn, his old master, which Qui-Gon brings him back to the light before Obi-Wan makes the wrong choice, and instead of murdering the entire clan, just as Anakin did, as we all saw in Episode 2, Attack of the Clones, Obi-Wan comes up with a plan, not a violent one, but rather an unexpected one for the Raiders. He instead chooses to cut their clothes off to reveal their skin, which is a taboo to the Sand People, which would ultimately result in the others of their tribe coming to the decision of murdering them. This gives Obi-Wan just enough time to escape on the Bantha with the Vaporators and causes him to become a legend for the Sand People. So the last part there, the thing that I really want to go over involving Obi-Wan Kenobi doing that thing where he essentially cuts their clothes off. I don't know why that reminds me of something that Disney would do with the Obi-Wan Kenobi movie, but some of you guys may think of that as something cheesy. Some of you may view it as something actually rather clever, because with the Tusken Raiders looking like that, the other ones surrounding them would murder them in that state. So Obi-Wan Kenobi essentially killed them indirectly. It reminds me of a moment that we see in the movie The Revenant. If you guys go ahead and check out the ending, I won't spoil it, but there is a moment for Leonardo DiCaprio going up against his adversary. And what he does is actually an indirect way of killing the character, to put things easier there. So, looking at the Obi-Wan Kenobi movie, what's interesting is that I think that they're going to really take a lot of things from Legends and EU material, etc. And looking at The Last One Standing, which is a piece that is considered Legends for the Star Wars universe, it goes over this one bit in which, you know, Obi-Wan temporarily slips to the dark side of the Force and is just about ready to murder all of the Tusken Raiders, which would have put him down the dark path, and who knows where Obi-Wan would have, you know, actually went from there. But the real cool part is how you get to hear, or you read about, you know, Obi-Wan hearing the voice of Qui-Gon Jinn pulling him back to the light. There's something so spectacular and brilliant about that, that I think that something like that would really work very well in the Obi-Wan movie. Again, in the Obi-Wan movie, I think it should be altered from what I just described in this video, where you're having him have all of these different nightmares of Anakin Skywalker, and all these different nightmares of him losing his best friend, right? His brother, basically. As he says, "You were my brother, Anakin, I loved you." So, I think that, you know, we all know fear is one of the core causes to the dark side of the Force. Obi-Wan would be going through these nightmares, he would be having a lot of anxiety at night, waking up from these nightmares, which could be the foundation of him having a moment like this in the Obi-Wan film, where he's tempted to kill the Tusken Raiders before hearing the voice of Qui-Gon Jinn. And that could ultimately push Obi-Wan and make him more optimistic in his path, and I would say, I guess you could say, like, more, more involved in the training with, you know, Yoda remotely into seeing Qui-Gon Jinn visually. I think something like that would be brilliant. But anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about this moment in The Last One Standing featuring Obi-Wan Kenobi. It's a very interesting piece in which he slips to the dark side. If you guys would like to go ahead and read it up, go ahead and check it out. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Night to moon, we hear them moans again.